Hi, I'm Chris Mikoski. Welcome to the NCAA Division I Football Championship Preview. Joined by Willie Fritz of Sam Houston State University and Craig Bull of North Dakota State University. And coaches, I'll start with you, coach, as the number one seed. Just your impressions so far of Frisco and the atmosphere leading up to the big game.
You know, we are very impressed with the hospitality that's been extended to us, and you know, they're really making this a first-rate game, and we're just very excited to be here.
Number two seed, North Dakota State, and coach, you guys obviously had a tough road to get here, a lot of quality opponents, but now that you're here in Frisco, what have you seen so far?
Well, this is truly a home run, if you could equate it to a baseball term. And I've been really duly impressed with everything that Frisco has to offer. It's a great game day venue. Two really quality opponents, and I can't think anything that's going to be better on the 7th.
And you knew that you had a great group of student-athletes coming into the season, I'm sure, but what was the moment? When did it click that this could be a group that would make it all the way to Frisco?
Oh, I'd say about a minute left to go in our last game, as coach would probably echo this, is all the teams that you play in the tournament are very competitive games. We felt like going into the year we had a makeup of a good quality football team, but the margins for victory are so slim, and so we're really fortunate to be where we're at right now.
Coach, same question to you. Just when did you realize that this was a group that could make this kind of a run, undefeated and in the championship game?
You know, about halfway through our conference schedule, I thought we had a chance to you know, win the conference, and but getting into the playoffs was something totally new to myself and our team, and so it was a learning process for us in the playoffs, and we're just very fortunate and happy to be where we're at right now.
A lot of good things go into having 3 weeks between games. Fans get to make their plans, players get to heal up. What are you most excited about, having a little extra time to prepare for North Dakota State?
Well, and coach would say the same thing as I believe. You know, it's really taxing both physically and mentally to play 14 games in a row like both of us did, and against quality opponents these last few weeks. So I think it's good to have the break right now, recharge your batteries, get healed up a little bit, and you know, and have a good preparation for a quality opponent.
And Coach Bull, a couple of your players, this gives them some time to recover. Mm-hmm. Ryan Smith with hamstring issue, Brock Jensen with turf toe. I'm sure there are others who are a little dinged up, and this 3 weeks is going to really help.
Well, without question, you go through a competitive playoff run like that, guys are going to have some bumps and bruises. We're pleased, though, there's not anybody that's going to be excluded because of a serious knee injury or anything like that. And coach would echo this. You know, you want all your players to have an opportunity to play in a game like this. So we'll take a measured approach getting ready. Certain players probably need more practice repetition than others. Finals are done now, mm-hmm. and so our guys are looking forward to this ball game.
This is a preview of the NCAA Division I Football Championship. I'm Chris Mikoski, joined by Willie Fritz and Craig Bull. And let's go into a little bit of your background, coach. 13 years at Central Missouri, most wins anybody's had in that program, 97 of them. You make the move to Division I and Sam Houston State. Why did you decide that it was the right time to make that move up and it was the right program and where you wanted to be?
Well, I'd been at Sam Houston before. I'd gotten my graduate degree there, and then also I'd been an assistant coach there in the early 90s and knew a lot about the university. Good friends with the athletic director. That also helps when you work for somebody that you can trust and have confidence in. And it was also a real good time for my family to go ahead and move. So there's a lot of different components in moving down to Huntsville.
And coach, your first job mm-hmm. as a full-time coach was at North Dakota State. Right. So obviously, like Coach Fritz, you had a great impression of the place the first time around, and obviously it worked out to be an incredible fit for you.
Well, it certainly has been. You know, the university made a decision to transition from Division II to Division I, and so there was a period, and to be able to lead our program during that time was certainly rewarding. This is what we were aiming for, to have an opportunity to win a national championship.
And it is the first time for both the Bison and the Bearcats to reach the Division I championship, and they wouldn't have been able to do it without some of these outstanding student-athletes, and All-America teams have been released, so we may as well start with those players. And for you, Coach, Chris Crockett, Travis Watson, You know, everybody talks about the flash on the offense, the speed guys, but those are the two that really drive the train. Incredible young men that make everything possible.
Yeah, they really do. They're both seniors for us. We don't have a whole lot of seniors. Those guys have been through some tough times. A new coaching staff came in. They could have chosen not to embrace us, but they've been just tremendous leaders for us and have really done a good job of not only protecting our passer, but opening up holes. And both great students, great young men. We're really proud of them.
And staying on the offensive side, a second team All-America selection, sophomore Tim Flanders, and your counterpart on Montana's side compared him to Barry Sanders during the semifinal week. So you can't get much higher praise than that.
No,
just
can't.
An amazing player.
Well, he's an excellent player. He's first team All-American in the AFCA. All-Americans that were released about 2 weeks ago. Outstanding player, got great balance. He can run in between the tackles and outside on the perimeter. He'll block you. Does a good job of receiving the ball and just a quality overall back.
And from right down the street over in Mesquite, Texas, Darnell Taylor is a first team safety on several All-America ball clubs, obviously well-deserving, and his brother joining him on that side. I can't imagine a bigger blessing to you than to have those two decide they wanted to play college football together.
Well, it's really great to have those two guys. You know, before the game against Montana, I kind of grabbed them both and said, you know, what a opportunity here for, you know, two twin brothers to go out in here and play for a chance to compete for a national championship. They're both outstanding players for us, both really physical guys. Darnell's a safety for us and leads our team in tackles. And then Darius plays a lot of linebacker and is also a big-time contributor in the kicking game.
I'm sure fans on both sides could have plenty of points about which team has the better defense. You have plenty of points on either way, but as far as the North Dakota State defense, Marcus Williams leading the way, another deserving All-America mm-hmm. choice. Tell us a little bit about that young man.
Well, Marcus is a really gifted athlete. He was a great basketball player in high school. Did not know if he really wanted to play college football. I can remember a Clemson basketball coach saying he wanted to recruit him as a point guard, but he couldn't shoot well enough. But he can sure cover, so it sounded like a cover corner to me. Marcus has been an outstanding special teams player also, and a great young man because even though he's young, he's always trying to get better. He doesn't have all the answers, and has really made a big, big impact on our defense.
And on offense, Paul Kornick is mm-hmm. somebody who has been recognized. We talked about this before we started the show, but you call this group the Rams.
The Rams.
Talk about that outstanding group of players.
Well, you know what? Anytime you're talking about North Dakota State, not only now, but in the years when NDSU won national championships at the Division II level, it was always started by the Rams, and those are the guys up front, and a lot of big, strong guys, and really believe in coming off the football and hitting people in the mouth. And Paul, I guess, epitomizes that group. He's a soft-spoken guy, but he carries a big stick, and he's one of our senior captains as well.
Let's go into the quarterback comparison. Really incredible numbers for both QBs. We'll start with Brock Jensen, 13 touchdowns on just 3 interceptions mm-hmm. all season. Incredible numbers and obviously a leader in the huddle.
Well, he's done a great job. He's a sophomore, which, like Sam too, you know, it's unique to have a guy at that early age playing the way he has. He's an athletic guy. He's been hampered a little bit by turf toe. He's worked through that. But he's really done an exceptional job taking care of the football, not putting the football in harm's way. You know, if the pass isn't there, let's go ahead and hold the football and not give up an interception. Our defensive coach is sure like that.
This is the Division I Championship Preview. I'm Chris Mikoski. The game coming up January 7th here at Pizza Hut Park in Frisco, Texas. Sold out, so you might have a hard time getting in, but we hope you'll tune in on ESPN2 if you can't make your way into the stadium. And coach, your quarterback, Brian Bell, as we said, a sophomore as well, another incredible field general, and his numbers are even more impressive perhaps. 20 touchdowns, didn't get as many opportunities to throw the ball as Brock did during the season, but still put up some impressive numbers. And obviously the biggest thing past 20 touchdowns, an undefeated campaign. You can't do that without an incredible QB.
Well, we threw Brian in the fire last year. He started the last 9 games as a true freshman. Got a lot of experience last season, came back really as a veteran. And one of the areas that we had to get much better in was our passing efficiency. We don't throw it a whole lot, but we want to try to get you to defend the whole field. And he's done an excellent job of throwing the ball downfield. And we've done a good job of catching it this season. That was kind of our Achilles heel last year. So Brian's had an outstanding season for us.
before we let you go, let's just close it out with what this is supposed to be. It's fun. It's going to be a great football game between two incredible institutions. And, you know, these guys are basically in bunkers throughout the entire season preparing their teams for battle. But, you know, it's an incredible thing. The Huntsville community, the Fargo-Moorhead community, everybody has embraced this as what it is, as a great job by these outstanding student athletes. I'm sure you're having a little bit of fun with this.
No, we're having a great time. I tell our guys all the time to make sure they live in the moment. And this doesn't happen every day. You'd like for it to, but it's tough to get to this point. And we're just very, very excited about representing Sam Houston in this national championship game.
And Coach, like I said, it hadn't been that long that North Dakota State has even been at the Division I level. Right. To be here now and to have a chance to win that trophy that we've all been looking at, that beautiful thing that says right. Division I champions, you must be having some fun as well.
Well, we certainly are. There's a lot of hard work and a collaborative effort by a whole lot of people that have played into this. And but our players have worked extremely hard. They've got a great bounce in their step, and you know, come game time, there's nobody going to be more excited than these two teams with the student athletes.
Yes, sir. Coach Bull, I appreciate
it. You bet. Thank you.
Coach Willie Fritz,
thank
you very much. I'm Chris Mikoski. This has been the NCAA Division I football preview. Again, the championship game coming up Saturday, January 7th, high noon at Pizza Hut Park in Frisco, Texas. Thanks for watching.